Come here, Gizmo. Stay back.
Made it. 45 minutes, right on point. Who's this?
That's Gizmo.
Gizmo, are you ready to go bye-bye? Ready to go for a ride? Huh? Oh, you are excited. Yeah, you are. We need to take you elk hunting. Yeah. You'd be a good tracking dog. Yeah, you would. What is your good deed?
Having the opportunity to hunt New Mexico had been something I'd dreamed about for several years. Since we already had a great relationship with Hunters New Mexico, I was really excited to find out Brad and I would be able to hunt the second season. I'd be hunting the first 5 days and Brad the final five. Reports I was getting from Eddie indicated the rut was going to be late due to the hot and dry weather conditions. It seemed like the timing was going to be perfect for our hunt. My optimism was off the charts.
Rex and Ryan.
I'm Ryan. Yes.
Ryan, pleased to meet you, bud. Dennis,
nice for
you. Welcome. This is camp. This is where we'll find a place for the trailer. And,
okay.
And that way super. You can unhook. And talking about me.
6x6 command with three cows. We spotted him up on top of the hill. It was beautiful all the way down. This wind has been swirling so bad in here. I know the cows came up and they were nervous. And now they're getting windows. They're back up the hill. He's still up there, bugling. I don't think he's going to come back.
As my hunt wound down to the last 2 days, we located a large herd, which brought new life to the hunt. They seemed to be much more vocal and engaged. I was encouraged that either I would get an opportunity on the last day, or knowing that Brad was coming in, that he'd be able to complete the story. Meeting up with Brad on the last day, I had a lot of information to relay to him, which gave me high hopes that he would not have a repeat of all my trials and tribulations of the week.
So we're going into this water hole. A lot of activity. About 5-7 days ago, Rex was in here, so we're gonna go in and try to clean up what he couldn't get done. Here we go.
We've already done 5.3 miles. We started bugling about 3:15 yesterday. It's 2:40 now. We should be in there in about an hour.
Here. These elk were in these fingers last night, and this morning there was two big old herds right over here with about 15, 20 cows apiece in, and there's three or four bulls up this drainage just over the rise from where we hunted the wallow last night.
As I got reports from Brad on day two and day three, it seemed nothing had changed and he just couldn't catch a break. His guide Eddie had been trying different areas and different tactics, but the same results.
Shooter.
first love was a wicked, twisted road. I hit the million mile mark at 17 years old.
It's always amazing to me how expectations change into realities as hunts come to an end. As we all know in life, nothing is guaranteed. Both Brad and I know this well. No, we did not harvest a bull, but our real takeaway was simply having the opportunity to share the same domain with these elusive animals. Our special thanks goes out to Dennis and Eddie, our guides, for their years of experience in hospitality. To me, success isn't necessarily measured by the harvest, but more by the total experience, which these two were part of. Two of the best I've ever known.
Let me see that camera, man, while it's rolling. Okay, just to show you that there is work involved. It's not all fun and play. Here's the guy that's doing all the work right here. And he's packing all this up here, about 35, 40 pounds. May not sound like much, but when you're going 4 or 5 miles, sometimes 10 miles a day.
Nope, they're not here.
Well, one thing we have in common with Missouri, there's flies here.
What are you taking all these pictures of and stuff for?
It's gonna be on TV, hopefully. Kill something.
Nice.
You okay with that?
If you want an interview, I'll have to fluff up my hair. So here's
okay, the blue jay.
Blue jay.
Got it. Great.